How are thee?
Let's get to the bottom of this.
不论语音还是文字，都能让人忘记眼前对话的，其实是一个人工智慧聊天机器人。Character AI 利用人物性格塑造的对话方式，立刻成为话题。
Character.ai launched its software last September and has had more than 173 million visits last month, a 61% increase from March.
Somebody who sends one message today is active.For on average 2 hours in that day.
超强的粘着度让 Character AI 成为独角兽，市值超过$10亿，吸引 Google 跟这间新创公司签订技术授权合作，并且延揽两位公司共同创办人，也是前 Google AI 部门的员工重返老东家。
Every person on earth is going to be inventing their own applications.
沙泽尔比谁都要了解 AI 市场，尽管新创公司表现亮眼，但研发跟云端运算都需要烧钱，就算已经成为独角兽，也不得不向科技大厂低头。
A big cost center for these startups is GPUs, those chips, cloud computing, and what does Amazon have? They've got AWS, they've got the cloud computing side in spades. So if you're a startup and you're looking to partner with one of these companies or do some sort of licensing deal, you're going to look at one of the big tech companies, likely Amazon.Google, Microsoft.
新创公司需要资金跟设备，而这些巨头则是急需要 AI 人才，因此一拍即合。
There's a very small number of researchers, AI practitioners that operate at the frontier of the technology. There's probably only thousands right now, and the hyperscalers, the megacaps, want that talent, and they're looking to get it any way they can.
以往像是 Google.微软、亚马逊这些巨头企业都是利用收购 AI 新创公司的方式取得相关人才还有专利技术，像是2014年 Google 收购 DeepMind， 结果放到现在各国陆续祭出监管机制，深陷反托拉斯的 Google 恐怕没办法收购像这样一家独立的 AI 研究公司。
At this moment AI is a nascent technology that could catalyze enormous growth and innovation. There is enormous opportunity hereFor a vibrant market, but we also see risk. We see risk of consolidation.
这样的合作看起来比收购案安全，应该是双赢的合作机会。
In a number of deals of this type, the remaining company still has access to the IP that's been created, and certainly enough resources as part of the transaction to continue to hire talent.And build upon that IP.
但实际上，大型科技公司投入大量的经费合作，就是要让顶尖的技术人员成为科技巨头的开发小组。但原本的新创公司，包括业务还有公关，却被迫守着空壳公司，还得在这样的情况下做出业绩。而且专家认为，这样游走在灰色地带的方式，科技巨头依然能掌握大量的顶尖技术。这些因为 AI 收购以及合作的假象，也逐渐冲击生成式 AI。AI 的发展格局。体育业新闻综合报道。